The Lord our God is a shield and a buckler to me, to protect the heart and the soul that in covenant be with him to make a covenant, and with the Son of Man, and to be every protection for all of them that can believe by faith and walk in trust along with Christ Jesus, that come what may and whatever trials he brings to us, whatever sort of madness may, and whatever trials, that like his Son in perfecting, comforting all the while, that within them also with them he will never forsake, and by and through the Son of God he will his children make. Through many sorrows and reproach to perfect his children, the disciplines of a father with only love for them. It's time, Father, to leave your home, enter into judgment, to come out of your dwelling place and from those you have sent. The Son of Man, he is your home within the heart of them, and to enter into judgment with the remnant of men. You had created Adam for a dwelling and a home, to walk in the cool of the day with them in the garden. But choosing to rebel against you, they have made their choice. They then decided that they would not listen to your voice. That is the choosing and the choice of unrepentant hearts. The unredeemable spirit that from you then depart. The blasphemy of your spirit and the Holy Spirit's rejection and the unbelief, the choice to not hear it. Rejection unforgivable and of its blasphemy, blaspheming the Holy Spirit and choosing deceiving. from which there is no coming back, and from a departure away and from the only truth, from the foundation sure. Yet all those that choose to remain and remain a remnant and cling to the only true hope in the one he has sent, to remain in his covenant and as his true vessels remain true unto the true God and Father, and do tell of his truth and of his witness and his loving kindness, and turn away from deception and turn from their blindness. Those vessels of the house of God are those children, the saints, the vessels of worship to him, give praise without complaint. The earthen vessels giving praise in which the word is tried, it's seven times in the vessels in the temple abide. The home of God are these, the ones that are they in Jesus, the vessels of worship giving in thankful sacrifice. The praise and worship of our God, and worship the Father, the one and only anointing above all his brothers. Is the anointing to rejoice, the oil of gladness, that through trials and the hardships, praise God in thankfulness? This is the anointing of Christ, the joy set before him. Endured the cross, despised the shame, is set at the right hand. Within the very throne of God, for he authored our faith, and he became its completion, and to give to the saints the faith it's all about. This faith he perfected, the faith in God through good or bad, all he has provided. That for the joy set before him, endured whatever sent, whatever God provided him, his perfect providence. This is the anointing oil and the rejoicing praise, for which we worship our Father and all he has us gave. The small and great vessels of praise are the children along. With the outcasts I gave my son, that pour out praise in song. I will remove the nail that I had hung him upon, and cut down the remnant to fall and cast off their burden. The burden of the covenant that I had placed on him, that all those that remain will be cut down in their own sin. I think I'm in a tragedy of heartbreaking content. Straight out of the pages of Job, and unto me God sent. If my life were any sadder, there would be nothing left. And if one more thing were taken, would be therein bereft. My Father, he is the author, the greatest of them all. And my story, it shall not end as with an empty stall. My life has been sheer poetry, my story magnifique. In the telling, its perfection and its detail sweet. With comedy and tragedy in perfect harmony, the beauty and the darkness of glorious artistry. The artistry of the author and finisher of faith does ask of me to knowingly come then to face my death. And with joy and a thankful heart to enter in with him as his beloved and body with the children of men. By covenant in this transit, this ever-changing life, one that we may join with him in, to be bound as a wife. For God is creating something so beautiful and good, out of something temporary, eternal, that he would create a home for himself in, a creature taking part in the unfolding covenant, willingly from the start, participating in his own story of his demise, and having to trust God by faith to see with his own eyes. For the end of a thing is then better than is the start. How beautiful are them, the feet of the man-child art. In a world absent of faith, believing in nothing, a man who can hold to his faith is a marvelous thing. A miracle for to behold, and beauty in the eyes of the creator of this thing unbelieving denies. God's holy word is a shield, and also is the sword of the vengeance that God promised within his holy word. And when spoken song in worship is every protection that the Lord God has promises within, without, and in. The word of God is all that is of every need needed. The majesty and dimensions within it infinite. So give ye praise and all glory unto God our Father. Make no mistake, he shall finish that which he has authored.